Have you ever seen a humanoid robot that looked almost, but not quite human, and felt an eerie, unsettling chill? That strange discomfort you experience is called the Uncanny Valley, a mysterious gap where robots look so human-like they almost feel alive, but not quite enough, making us uneasy. Today, we're diving deep into what causes this Uncanny Valley, why it matters, and how modern robotics is beginning to not only explore it but transcend it entirely. Humanoid robots have fascinated scientists, engineers, and science fiction fans for decades. The goal is to create robots that move, behave, and even emote like humans. But as these machines become more lifelike, they sometimes fall into the uncanny valley, where their appearance or behavior is close enough to human to be recognizable, but just off enough to trigger a subconscious sense of eeriness or discomfort. Why does this happen? Our brains are wired to pick up subtle cues in human faces and movements. Tiny irregularities in skin texture, eye movement, or speech rhythm can send warning signals. These cues evolved to help us distinguish between familiar humans and potential threats. When a robot hits this awkward middle ground, too human to be clearly a machine but too unnatural to be fully human, it can create an uncanny effect. Modern advances in AI, material science, and robotics are beginning to tackle this challenge head-on. Innovations like ultra-realistic synthetic skin, micro-expressions, and natural language processing are helping robots bridge that gap. Some robots are now so convincing that they no longer trigger the uncanny valley, instead evoking empathy and trust. But the goal isn't just to mimic humans perfectly. The future of humanoid robotics may lie beyond the uncanny valley, in creating robots that are distinctly artificial yet emotionally engaging, with their own unique identities. By embracing a new form of robotic realism, we might build machines that are relatable without being unsettling. The uncanny valley is more than just a quirk of human perception. It's a challenge pushing the boundaries of technology, psychology, and design. As we continue to explore and exceed it, we're not just building better robots, we're reshaping how humans and machines connect on a deeper level. So, what do you think the future holds? Will robots ever truly feel human, or will we embrace their difference? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. Let's keep the conversation going.